Hello Smite fans, and welcome to the fourth week of the Smite Oceanic Pro League. It is my great pleasure to be bringing you Deadweight versus Llamas in pyjamas, but of course, my name is Parathus. Casting with me once again is my good friend Lynx. Now, Lynx, Deadweight versus Llamas, they versed in the second week of the OPL. I've got a few questions for you. What went wrong in that game for Llamas in pyjamas? Why did they end up losing to it at Deadweight? And also branching off of that, what do you think Llamas in pyjamas can do differently to week number two in this week against Deadweight?
Well, the first game was simply due to a lack of objective control. We've seen in the past, Llamas aren't the best at closing out games. Well, game number two, they lost simply because Shreds Kibraken got so monstrous, they literally couldn't shut him down or the rest of the team. And they got steamrolled in about 28 minutes. This week, what they need to do, they need to drop a comp that one is actually based on teamfighting, not for picking people off. Secondly, yep. They need to get rid of Shreds Kibraken, ban it or pick it themselves. And I think that's basically, they need to change their strategy because last week they just got steamrolled by Deadweight.
Well, speaking of banning Shreds Kibraken, let's go ahead and jump into picks and bans in just a second for you guys. So, as you've already mentioned, as you've already said, Deadweight banning away Kibraken, or Llamas in Pyjamas should be looking to ban that away, but also a few things for Llamas. Shurix is going to be in that solo lane, and he has been playing monstrously on that Ravana, so Deadweight could look to ban that.
Yes, however, the Susanoo ban coming out first is no surprise. Currently considered probably the strongest god in the game, and until he gets nerfs next patch, he is going to stay that way. Pyugi is an extremely smart ban against Deadweight. Even though HS is not playing this week, Horizon is subbing in. We've seen Horizon play in that second week against Llamas, do an incredible job on Pyugi, getting those ricochets. He's just an incredible 1v1 player. Ryujin coming as your third ban.
Yeah, a lot of these high bursty damaging gods coming out for bans in this in the first slot for Deadweight, really focusing away a lot of those high damage carry rolls. Llamas still looking to ban. It's going to be that Guan Yu. That leaves a lot of things open for both of our teams here. We see an Athena open. Shurix plays that very well in that solo lane as well. Kepri is open. Athena instantly locked in there for Deadweight. No surprise at all, Lynx.
Yeah, as we saw last week, Weave did an incredible job with HS against Pandemonium on Athena, getting all those taunts to the right place. And if you can set that up with the mid laner, because Agony picks has picked Scylla and Sol in the past, we've seen devastating amounts of damage coming out. The Guan Yu ban was targeted at Weave because he is known for playing warrior supports, but recently he's kind of shaken it up and actually started picking more of the conventional supports, and this week is no different. Kepri and Kibraken supposedly going in the way of Llamas, completely taking away Shreds Kibraken.
Yeah, I can almost guarantee that Deadweight were hesitant about that. They have to pick Athena, but also Kibraken's on the board for Shreds, so I like picking the Athena over it, and also denying it for Deadweight, so that'll be going. Kibraken possibly in the solo lane, could also be in that jungle role as well. Deadweight locking in our Kwong and Scylla, a very strong mid laner and jungle.
Yeah, I absolutely love Ogre drafting the our Kwong. He is known for those hyper carry junglers. He comes out into the mid and late game and just bursts everyone down. And it's actually got a very good counter to the Kepri, because he can go through the Scarab's Blessing and still execute someone. And while you're at it, the Scylla goes very nicely with the Athena. You get the taunt into the armor monster. That is dead person, which will be Zeus, who has very little mobility in the mid lane.
Llamas in pyjamas banning out Odin here. I would have liked to see them maybe skip the Odin ban and maybe look to pick it up for themselves. They have... it could have been played in jungle, but I love the Thunder Dome. Basically, you play Odin, you jump in, use that Ring of Spears, and then Zeus just comes in, uses that Thunder Ultimate, and just stomps everyone inside. It's a vicious combo, and we have seen it played to its full extent. Thor getting banned out here for Deadweight, so really looking to focus away the jungler for Llamas in pyjamas.
And then we see an Apollo ban coming out again. They're really trying to ban away Horizon and ensure he doesn't get a solid, aggressive ADC.
Strong. You can't let Horizon on a Hoi Yi or an Apollo. He's so good at boxing, as you said, 1v1 potential is very, very high for Horizon, so really looking to focus that away. Again, another jungler ban here for Deadweight as they take away Humbats. Humbats pairs fairly well with the Zeus as well. I really like that Kibraken as well pairs with. So they can look for a few things here. It's okay. It's going to be in a wheelish pick here for Llamas in pyjamas. I don't see any knockups on the side of Llamas.
And the only other spore knockup, really, they can grab the Scylla from underneath when she's essential, but that's it. I really don't like this Awilix. I said in the draft they shouldn't draft these gods that basically solo pick people off. Awilix is that kind of god. She can't do much in team fights. Compared, even though Alcmon can do that, at least Deadweight have the Athena, they have the Scylla and other gods to compensate for the fact that Alcmon is a very single pick oriented god. Hercules, Shibalanke will be the final picks for Deadweight, which are both very competent picks.
Yeah, I really like the Hercules and the Shibalanke as well. That'll be Horizon playing that. If Shibalanke can get those passive stacks online, get those early kills, which gives him more power, he can really come online very, very quickly. Artemis actually locked in here for Llamas in Pyjamas, so that is your two drafts here going into game number one. A bit of an odd draft here for Llamas in Pyjamas, to say the least. It'll be very interesting to see how Zachariah is actually going to be playing that Awilish.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, they have to get ahead early and make sure Shurix actually gets much farming as he needs. They don't want that Alcorn getting into the late game, because once he comes online, he's just going to be going into the back line, picking up Zeus, who is a very easy target. He is very immobile. We saw when Deadweight, I think it was Deadweight against Avant when that happened, they simply just kept diving the back line and just picked. Actually, no, sorry, that was against Pandemonium when they were just diving the back line and picking off the Zeus when Ocheeta just couldn't do anything about it. So if Oki can get into that very comfortable position, he'll do absolutely fine. And Shred picking Hercules means he can be his aggressive self as per usual. Shred is kind of similar to Omega in North America. He just has that aggressive presence. I'm not sure Shurix, even on that Kabrakan, can manage to deal with Shred.
Yeah, but Kabrakan is fairly safe in lane as well. So don't expect a lot of first bloods to come through. But again, only good at solo. As soon as he hits level 5, looking for that King of the Eastern Seas ultimate, looking to maybe go on to Shurix if he's taken low from that Hercules. Because we all know, the versing of Hercules in lane, if you are hit by that Earthbreak and the Driving Strike combo into your tower, it's almost first blood guaranteed.
And not to mention, Kabrakan uses usually Tremors to clear the wave. He is standing still. He is a...
It's easy to pull.
It's literally a sitting duck as a target to pick him up. Well, usually what we see, which we're seeing right now, is Shred Huji likes going from blue to speed to the mid camps to deny farm from the mid lane of the enemy team. And I kind of like this, even though he usually does end up missing a wave in the solo lane, he usually always seems to get ahead of the solo lane and then punish them later on.
Well, yeah, Shred has a fairly good clear as well, and Zachariah looking to go here, but didn't manage to secure any of those. Shred's going to be going back into his lane. Shurix is going to be happy. He's freezing the wave at this point, just trying to deny a little bit more farm. But in the meanwhile, Shred's getting even more farm by those fire and elementals by himself.
However, over in the door lane, not surprisingly, Kepri and Artemis just absolutely have the complete lane pressure. Kepri, the best support when it comes to lane clear. And Artemis, with the throwing dagger as well as a volley of arrows, just completely clears the wave in a matter of seconds. And even though Shibalaki can get that throwing dagger, combine that with his branching bowlers, Athena will be forced to play an aggressive role, and all Athena has to, I mean, not Athena, sorry, Kepri has to do is just abduct her back away into the Artemis.
Having a look in our mid lane, Zac and Swifty are going to be taking away the back camps here for Deadweight, so they're going to be denying a little bit more farm for Deadweight. I like the combo here. Swifty, as I've mentioned, playing that Zeus. It works well with a Kabrakan as well. If Kabrakan can use the tectonic shift, trap someone in, trap them in that big ultimate from the Zeus, the lightning storm, and then just pair it up. Even Tori, abduct into a lightning storm is vicious.
They do need to be careful though, because Athena can simply taunt out the abduct and make the channeling completely a waste of time. And every single person on the side of Deadweight has some sort of leap or dash just to get away from this team. So they really need to play to the advantage of the works and maybe try and land in the back of that moonlight charge. We mentioned the draft, how there's not that many knockups, so Zachariah will have a very hard time trying to find those gravity surge to catch people out of position, but otherwise, it's going to be a very rough game for Llamas in Pyjamas.
Yeah, Zachariah really needs to be on point here. Looking to come over here into the solo lane. Shurik's taken very low, but so is Shred, and here comes that Awilish as well. The driving strike, but Zach is going to pick up the first blood of the game with an easy feather step to take out Shred, who played a little bit aggressive against Shurix, and the rotation from Zach was just too strong.
That was a bit too easy. Simply, he was just way out of position and too low health. And all, as you saw there, Zach, right, all he had to do was just feather step. That's literally all he had to do. And yeah, he had a red pot. So basically, that's your red pot validated right there. Getting that first blood is what Llamas really need. They need to get ahead. They need to finish this game early and not allow Deadweight to get online.
Not all. Speaking of coming online, we do see Ogre just hitting level 5, so he does have that big dragon ultimate for that execute. As you said in the picks and bans, Tori with that Scarab's Blessing is going to be completely negated if Ogre can get a really good ultimate and cancel out that revive.
And with the Alcorn in the late game especially, like, I'm just waiting to see him just dive the backline constantly.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun
even
game.
Even if Kepri tries to ad-buck someone and say someone in the backline, as I mentioned, Athena can just simply confound and completely negate it. So basically, Deadweight have completely counter-drafted against Llamas and Pyjamas, and they still have a very similar draft to what they usually do, which is a very aggressive, positioning-oriented draft, forcing people into very uncomfortable places, forcing teamfights, and then getting easy pickoffs.
Once again, Zach's going to be taking away those boars in that duo lane, getting even more farm. He's already level 6. He is about 500 gold in front of Only Good at Soga due to that first blood and also a little bit of invading the camps for Deadweight. So Awilich coming online very, very quickly. And as you said, with that red pot already finishing off that warrior Tabwai, if he can get caught out, I mean, Zach's going to be doing a lot of damage.
Yes, and if we actually have a look at our duel lane now, we can see that both the supports have actually stayed for quite a bit longer than they usually do, just making sure
forced to use the beads there. Really good Moonlight charge there coming through from Zachariah. That's the thing, if you have beads online, you really need to just keep your calm when you get knocked up into the air with a Wheelich around you. Really good play there from Zach, forcing the beads from Agony.
I don't know if that was the smartest. Yeah, as you said, the beads were maybe a little bit too preemptive, but you can never be too safe. Scylla, you kind of want to get online. And maybe I'd understand more using the purification beads if she actually had started building a Doom Orb. But since Agony isn't building a Doom Orb, right now it may have been okay to kind of sacrifice yourself. You're only level 7, the cooldown timers aren't that long. And Swifty, I feel like he usually plays gods like Yannis, so he's not on the most comfortable of gods. He doesn't have that mobility he usually has. So I feel like Agony can be a bit more risky and accept a death than forced to use a purification and then get caught out later on when he actually needs to save himself.
But you still don't want to get Zachariah 2-0. If he had pulled in the Scylla and got an easy 2-0, it's just going to be an easy lead. Llamas in Pyjamas going for another lead, trying to take out Gold Fury here. However, the ward coverage is good for Deadweight, and they should be looking to come over here. Lightning Storm coming through from Zachariah, and there's that Dark of the Night. Deadweight take the Gold Fury from Llamas in Pyjamas, and Only Good at Solo falls down in return to Ogre playing that Alquong.
That was way too easy. They should have known by that point that Ogre had the ultimate online. And especially if they could see, I think he was actually like spotted by the minion, so they should have known he was right next to them. I think they were spotted out by a ward. I think it was possibly the one right next to the mid cams around the bottom side of the Gold Fury possibly. So they just made it way too easy to steal, and they popped the ultimates just a little bit too early. The problem with the Zeus ult, even though it does a lot of damage, it does it over time, kind of similar to a Huyi Sunbreaker. So it's not that instant damage like an Ice to Circle of Protection. So they were just able to come and sweep it away. Having a look at our graphs now, they've completely shifted over back in the favor of Deadweight when it comes to XP. 1000 experience, however, the gold difference still in the favor of Llamas. The XP difference is in favor of Llamas, while Deadweight have slowly brought it back thanks to that gold tier win due to the fact that they were able to get first blood. Llamas still retaining a very solid lead.
I'm just having a look at Ogre here. He's building into that Imperial Helmet on that Alcong. What are your thoughts? Usually you see this on a lot of the mid laners who aren't too comfortable. They want to have a little bit of protection. Do you like it on the Alcong?
Personally, I like going into the Polynomicon simply because it just boosts your auto attacks as well as the Wildstorm Dragon Claw combo. But yeah, if he wants to be, from my understanding, basically if he's going to try and die at the backline, if he does get caught out by the Wheelix, gets feather stepped, he's going to be taking a lot of damage. So he just kind of wants to get those physical protections, but still wants to output a lot of damage. So he just needs to be very careful. And that's kind of smart of him. Later on, he can possibly look to sell it off and get a different item. But for now, it's pretty clever because Alquong takes a bit of time to come online and he needs his time and the gold to get online.
Big grouping here. The left side mid camps, our supports have rotated over. Tori doing a good job at zoning away Agony, whose beads are down for another. Oh no, they've actually come online now. So Darks of Night's getting used. Have a look at the Joy Lane though. Rana falls down to Only Good at Solo. And that taunt from Weave is just so strong. Ogre using that ult to make sure Zachariah cannot aggress any further. But Kepri is rotated over, and it's a full reset for Deadweight as they pick up their second kill of the game.
Yes, that was an extremely easy kill. Artemis has the simple issue that she simply doesn't have any form of dash or leaps. So with that Darkness of Night, combining that with the taunt, even though Artemis has a way to increase her movement speed, she just wasn't going to get away. And Alquong, with that Water Illusion, able to easily catch up to her, slow her with the Dragon Call, and then just pick up the very easy kill. That's the problem. Artemis is a high-risk, high-reward god who only comes online quite late into the game. So they need to keep Artemis alive, and they just haven't been able to keep her alive.
And as we go later into the game, it's going to be even harder to keep Rana alive, especially as you mentioned, Weave using that taunt perfectly, but as well as Shred. If Shred in a team fight late game can get an easy Earthbreaker and Driving Strike combo, pulling you into the team, have a look. Shred trying to invade, gets caught out here, but Ogre is here to back him up as well. But look at the damage coming through from Shuix. Playing Kabrakan is just too strong.
However, he was able to steal the blue buff, Shred, so he can be happy with that, even though he won't be able to pick it up. It's still a little bit, it's a minor victory for him. And even though Shurik has got the, he won't have that much money, he hasn't gone into something like a Vampiric Shroud or a Soulstone. So it makes it a lot harder for Shurik to win late. Shred, however, very much needs that blue buff and is able to secure his own one. So he is in a very okay place.
Fire Elemental is now picked up by Ogre, and the rotation to mid has once again begun. Ogre hitting level 10 still. Actually, he's actually brought the lead back closer to Zakrai. Only about 100 gold separates them. Ogre now has 2 kills and he's coming online very, very quickly on that Alcorn, finishing off his Dynasty Plate Helm already. As he said, a lot of protections for him. Getting abducted in the mid lane. Taunt coming through in just a second onto the Crush. Execute, not even needed. Tori out of position. Swifty won't be able to save you from that one, and he falls down again. Ogre, 3 kills.
Yes, I think we're starting to see the remnants of Tori when he used to play jungle. So for people who don't know, this week Tori has actually switched over from the jungle to replace Dagna in the support role. And at that point, he was just way too far forward with someone who has a cripple, a taunt, as well as the burst of Alquan. That was just reckless. The only person even remotely close was Swifty, and Swifty can't do anything to save him there. Yeah, all he can true. Really do is throw out the shield and the arc lightning. So he really needs to be more careful, more communicative with his team and ensure he doesn't get caught out like that again, because you're just feeding Scylla kills.
Now, Gold Fury respawning in about 15 seconds here. Should be looking to be picked up here. If Llamas want to go for this early Gold Fury once again, they need to have full ward coverage. They need to have absolutely no minions chasing them and getting caught out. But they also need to save Swifty's ult and detonate charge till the very end, because just taking a look, really, the only thing that Deadweight can do to really steal it, other than just walk in and use a few abilities, is Agony with that I'm a Monster. So if Swifty can get a good detonate before Agony can come over and use that ult, it should be fairly easy for Llamas to take the second gold.
Yes, however, I don't think they're going to give it up the Gold Fury without a fight. Deadweight have very good objective control. They always seem to have wards up most of the time. And even now, they just were able to get that sentry finally back into the pit. And the ward war has actually begun. As you'll see, you'll probably see, as we can see, there are no sentry wards on the side of Llamas. But once they go back, pick it up again, they can try and deward it and just keep that vision on such a key objective early on. Obviously, later on in the game, we'll see Fire Giant become the hotspot, but for now, Gold Fury is that main objective people have in mind if they can win their team fights.
Having a look into our items as well, have a look. Kabrakan building into that blink that we usually see. I love it. Kabrakan blink coming in out of nowhere can just disorientate an entire team. And if you can't escape a Kabrakan, then that's almost GG for you. He does so much damage. Building into that should be a breastplate of valor, and then maybe building into more damaging items like your Void Stones, even your Soul Reaver. A blink Kabrakan is destructive to have on the enemy team.
Yes, and speaking of Shurik, he's actually currently rotating over to what looks like to possibly be a mid slash Gold Fury fight over by the duel line, though. Rana forced to run away there, and now Deadweight could possibly be looking to bait this Gold Fury.
Rana forced to use that bead, so he needs to be extremely careful in team fights. One taunt will spell disaster for him, and then it will make it an instant 4v5. Deadweight looking and just lurking around this left side jungle, could be looking to go onto Rana here, but he knows that the rotation is coming and he's able to back away under that tower, and neither team looking at Gold Fury any further.
No, currently there's just too many people up right now, especially it's a 3v3 matchup in the mid lane. You can't try and just take that Gold Fury. You're just going to get a lot of ample damage that isn't really necessary for you to take, and it's just a waste of time. For now, they're just sitting on a tower, getting ready for farm, getting ready for this team fight. And most likely, from what I think, Deadweight should win this team fight, especially with that Darkest of Nights.
Oh, Joyland though. Horizon gets taken out from Zachariah. Beads was used a little bit too early on that trap. Zachariah able to just get a clean rotation, pick up his second kill of the game, and looks to be building into a... Is that going to be a Wingblade?
That is most likely going to be, probably is going to be a Wingblade. However, Gold Fury are started by Llamas and Pyjamas with Weave, Agony, and Ogre in the area. They do need to be careful. It could be stolen away just like last time.
We've pulled into that ultimate as well. Tori taken very low. Zach gets a kill in the back line, but it's returned. And Ogre finds one onto Tori with the execute up in the air with that big dragon form. And Llamas come out almost on top of that fight, but Shred's actually DCing, so we're going into a quick pause. Should be getting unpaused here in just a second, however. But neither team picking up Gold Fury off of that. Was leeched a little bit too early.
I wouldn't say too early. If anything, Llamas did a great job. They knew that the Alcon could easily steal it away. So instead of doing that, they simply just return their attention onto just the rest of the team and use that abduct really well, forcing Agony to use the central. And when that happened, the gravity surge came through, pulled him from underneath, which is quite surprising, and then picked up a very easy kill.
No doubt. Game unpausing here in just a second now. Old Fury is being started up as well. And Llamas are now leading. Shred's just lurking in the background. Should be going to go onto Zachariah here. Driving Strike might come through in a second, but good ultimate there from Shrix to zone away. But Gold Fury was leeched, and Horizon's coming in with that Defender of Olympus.
And now that he's landed, the Poison Arts combined with the Confound as well as the Shield will all land at the same time. However, nothing is going to eventuate from it. Shrix way too tanky. Got that Seismic Crush to get him that increased movement speed. And the Gold Fury will be reset for, I believe, the third time already in the last minute. So, having a look at our builds, we can see Scylla is starting to build into a Book of Thoth, a much safer option than starting up with a Doom Orb, simply because we've seen in the past just now that Zachariah was able to get a very easy Gravity Surge onto Scylla, where she can't even use her Purification because she's mid-animation.
Once again, game is paused out here. I think Shred is having a bit connection issues, which is fairly surprising. 0-1 and 0 not playing as aggressive as we usually see him playing, although that might be due to a bit of high ping. Still, Deadweight are still one kill behind. Llamas in Pyjamas on the scoreboard. Taking a look into our graphs, Llamas in Pyjamas looking very, very dominative in this experience. Only about 3,000 experience in favor of them. Gold, however, fairly even.
Yeah, it doesn't surprise me that the gold is even, simply because they were able to steal their first gold through away. And as you said, it's only 4-5, and currently Ogre is 4-1. It is not something you want to see. He's definitely going to come online very shortly and just come into the late game. As you can see, he already has that tiny trinket in his inventory, and that will most certainly be going into that Polynomicon for the late game.
Yeah, usually we see Polynomicon built fairly early on an Alcon, typically around where that Dynasty Plate Helm is built, and then building into the Penetration. However, I like the Obsidian Shard built before the Polynomicon. It just works so well. Darkest of Nights used, try and catch out Tori here, but I'm not really sure what that ultimate was used there for.
As you said, they were trying to quit it, but they didn't have Alcon there. They had him in the solo lane. And they just had Athena, I think that was Horizon as well there. They just didn't really have the pressure to actually be able to kill him. Having a look at build now, we can actually see Shurix has gone a very interesting choice going into that Mystical Mail.
Yep. Yeah, I kind of said it would be building into a Breastplate. I don't know why. Breastplate's in the wrong item. My apologies for that. But Mystical Mail, I like it if you're stuck in the Tremors, and also if that Tectonic Shift comes down, you're just getting tick damage from the Mystical Mail, that 40 damage. But, I mean, it gives him a lot of health, gives him a lot of protections. It's not a bad item, it's just something we don't commonly see in solo lane.
Yes, as you said, I much would have rather see that actually the Breastplate of Valor. It just means your Tectonic Shift, everything, just every single one of your abilities, just on that quicker cooldown. And then you can obviously transition into that Voidstone, into that Soul Reaver for even more damage with quicker cooldowns. As you can see, Shurix rotating over for what may look to be another Gold Fury fight, Tori getting rooted out, plus the Crush hitting.
That's a significant amount of damage coming through. Only 23 stacks on that Book of Thoth. However, Tori doesn't really have that much magical protections other than that Heart of the Urchin and a few stacks on that. Having a look, big rotations here for both of our teams. Neither team looking to engage. That's usually the trouble with these teams. Shurix getting a good stun to Shred, but he doesn't manage to find the Driving Strike combo. And now it's looking aggressive to go onto Weave here. Good taunt onto two members. However, they're stuck in that Tectonic Shift. And in the back line though, have a look at Ogre doing so much damage, gets him up in the air, but the Sanctuary was good and Swifty manages to get out of there. Tori overall uses that Scarab's Blessing to try and get him out. Rana finds a kill onto Agony. Ogre just trying to run away from a tanky Kabrakan. Blink coming through, but I mean, that's a lot of movement speed coming through, and the Tremors should be able to find the kill. Ogre still juking. What?
However, Zachariah going to find a very easy kill. Rana getting the Driving Strike into him. However,
oh,
pop the Purification,
pull.
Is able to get away, just using that steroid to pop and get the hell out of there. And now this is full on retreat mode. They know they won. They're actually looking to find Ogre, who's extremely low in the solo jungle.
Yeah. Oh, if Ogre gets out of this, I'll eat my hat. He's juked the wrong way. Rana looking for him. Ogre still gets out, jukes the entire team. Shred doing a good job at baiting the enemy team while Ogre just backed at that speed camp. What a play there from Ogre. Didn't manage to find any kills. However, didn't die either in that fight. So, I mean, that was worth.
Yes, that was an extremely good job though by Swifty, popping that purification to completely negate that the ultimate from Alquong. And that basically, that shows the one weakness of Alquong. He is a single target god, and with that ultimate down, and with his rest of his abilities down, the only thing, as you can see, that is he can do is just water illusion away and hope he doesn't get caught in that backline, because he is usually engaging to the backline. He does have that blink in that active slot to usually either engage with or get away, but since that was on cooldown for quite a while, he was just forced to basically run around and actually miss out on quite a bit of farm. He may be the second highest level on his team, but he does need to be careful.
4-7. Llamas in Pyjamas getting even a bigger lead over Dead Weight, the team that took out Pandemonium last week, and have already 2-0'd Llamas in Pyjamas, who are looking very strong as we go into this game. But we also have to take into account the late game that Deadweight have drafted. Horizon is going to come online. We've already talked about Ogre just doing so much damage on that Alquong. Weave playing Athena is one of the most annoying things to verse late game. And also Agony, so strong, but good Gravity Surge is going to pull him in. Zachariah finds an easy kill. Just as we're talking about Agony falling down to the hands of Zachariah with the Gravity Surge Feather Step combo. Even though he's only got one knockup on his team, he's doing a damn good job at pulling them in.
We were so dismissive in the pick and ban phase, but look at him, he's out 5-0-2. As we've seen in every team fight, he's basically been doing the Alquong approach, but since I find the Athena's been just a little bit too far forward, he's been able to get free reign on Agony in the back line, which we thought would be happening too.
Rana Barana might be in some trouble here. Scarab's Blessing forced to be used, and the Sanctuary to back away. Good rotation from Deadweight, but Tori was there on that Kepri to keep his buddy a little bit more alive.
Yes, if he got caught out there, that would actually been huge. They could have possibly looked to engage possibly a team battle, even go for Gold Fury, since their main source, one of their main sources for damage on the Gold Fury with that steroid, will mean they can actually, Deadweight have a much easier chance. Deadweight getting a nice driving strike into Shurik's, but Shurik's just going to walk it off. He is building into what seems to be a height of the Urchin, so once he gets out line, just even more protections. He's going a very protections kind of build, but the only damage item he currently has being that Shoes of the Magi.
Yeah, so he has a little bit of pen and a little bit of power. Still, I want to have a look, even though he has... Yeah, of course, I was just about to say that. As you say, he has one damage item. He's topping the charts, basically, on player damage, and that is not surprising to see at all playing a Kabrakan this late in the game. Shred missing the driving strike combo, but Agony might be in a bit of trouble here as he's zoned away by the Kabrakan, and it's a good push here. Good abduct onto Shred. Might actually find the kill here, but Meditation and the Sprint should be popped in a second. Shred might actually get out of here. Rana trying to just do some damage over that wall. Doesn't manage to find anything. Good four-man taunt there into the big boulder there from Hercules himself. And Tori falls down to Ogre with an execute from Only Good at Solo. And now they turn the aggression around. And Agony finds a kill with that I'm a Monster. Shred finds another one onto Zachariah. And Rana, using that ultimate, might get away. But Horizon finds a kill of his own. Great turnaround there from Deadweight.
That was an extremely good turn, team fight there by Deadweight. Especially at the very beginning, Ogre was able to get a really nice water illusion just at the right time, because we saw that Shurik's was actually slowly rotating over with that blink. He was trying to land the tectonic shift, was able to really catch no one just simply because they were too quick for him. And then they easily, the minute they noticed that ultimate was down, they just turned it around. And Swifty had no protection in the backline. Once he's, if he gets caught in the backline, as you saw, he just gets absolutely destroyed. And now they may actually be possibly looking for this Gold Fury since everyone is down and the Defender of Olympus is used.
I think that it'll be an easy Gold Fury here for Deadweight. There's really no contestion whatsoever. Swifty gets his red buff. Tori's only just respawned and coming into the fight, but Deadweight managed to pick up a really good team fight for themselves and the Gold Fury on top of that. That's their second of the game. Taking a look into the graphs, we see the experience difference still in favor of Llamas and Pyjamas, but it has come muchly back towards that center middle line where they had a 3k lead. It's still going that back down into Llamas, but Deadweight bringing a little bit back in that experience, but they're really topping it in that gold difference. 2.5k gold 21 minutes in is quite impressive.
And if we have a look at our mid lane now, though, we can see that Llama is just taking that opportunity. That mid lane was basically dead. That the first tower finally to fall in this game. 21 minutes with 8 and 9 reading the scoreline. And now this game is, it's actually very even. I'm surprised Llamas are doing a lot better than last week. This is kind of reminds me of how game number 1 went instead of game number 2 where they just got absolutely destroyed. Especially after last week seeing Deadweight like beat Pandemonium 2-0, I expected this to actually be a demolition. I wouldn't have been surprised. But Llamas, even with a draft who I thought was actually going to lose, they've been putting up a very decent fight. However, as we get into this late game, Shubalanke is coming online and Al Kong is basically about to finish the Soul Reaver. Llamas have to be very careful. Even though they've been able to stay close so far, this may possibly be where they start to fall behind.
And now, I guess the objective game really starts for both of our teams here. Gold's down for another 3.5 minutes. Expect to maybe see a team fight in that time and then look to push some of these towers. But around this time is generally where we start seeing these massive 5v5 team fights, these big groups. People aren't really looking to, their laning phase is basically over at this point. Taunt coming through onto Tori in that dual lane. The ultimate is popped from Rana. Varana Weave taken extremely low, stuck in the trap from Rana Varana, but it's a good pull from Shred. Manages to find Rana, but the beads was good as well. Over the wall, we see a big armor monster, but it doesn't connect because the sanctuary is good. Shurix is in the fight now, and he's looking to go onto the members of Deadweight. Horizon still doing a lot of damage with those branching boulders, trying to go onto Rana. One more basic should find it, but Zach falls down to only good at solo in the meantime, and Tori has to get away from Weave, but Shurix is here to back him up as well. Good knock up there. Driving Strike finds two, and it's a good reset here for Deadweight.
Yes, that was an incredible play by Zachariah. If people didn't catch that, he was actually able to use the damage immune frames from Featherstep to actually completely negate the defender of Olympus. And if he was hit by that, that would have completely changed the teamfight. However, over in Tori. The lane, Tori getting extremely low, trying to run away. However, Horizon picking up the kill, but will fall to Shurix. That is a major pickup for Horizon. That will give him a little bit extra physical power. Shred now running away as he took quite a bit of damage there over from Swifty, and the Mystical Mail just absolutely destroying him.
They've stayed too long because Agony is right here as well. Good taunt coming on to Shruix, and there's that Crush Sikkim combo. Shred finds it with the Driving Strike, and Shruix stayed a bit too long. Hopefully, Swifty can get out of here and not be dove under this tower. Zach is lurking in the jungle. Shred, only about a quarter health, could be looking to take this tier 1 tower. Zach could find an easy knock-up overall. No, he doesn't find it. And the tier 1 tower should fall in the favor of Deadweight.
However, while that massive fight was going on, it turns out Wan was being very cheeky, just taking that solo lane tier 1 tower all by himself, just using the fact that he has that attack speed steroid to just quickly just destroy that tower. And now since it's 24 minutes into the game, almost has that Wind Demon online. This is no surprise whatsoever. And now Wan can just return to farming. Currently, 2-2-6, he's actually been doing very decently. And even when he has been caught out, he's been getting the backup from his team as needed, using that Caledonian Boar, and really just staying alive and actually getting a bit ahead of Horizon, because currently, even though Horizon is like 2-3-6, he has been not doing as well as Rana in this early game.
Left side tower is going to fall down to Llamas. There's not really any point of testing that. It's only about a quarter HP left on that tower. Just having a look at the player damage as well, you can really start to see how well Rana Barana is playing this Artemis. Topping the charts now, this has dropped off, doing about 18k player damage on that Artemis. 2-2-6, as you said, really doing so much for his team at this point. Solo lane though, Ogre returns it and actually finds a tower of his own. Good ultimate there from Ogre to make sure Shurix can't chase any further. And in the mid lane, it's another big grouping for both of our teams.
Yes, however, nothing was actually able to venture. You just missed a bunch of abducts as well as taunts coming out. Nothing did come. So now everyone's just going to back off again. Gold Fury will be spawning in only 20 seconds. And everyone can actually start possibly looking towards that Fire Giant, but they may just take this final Gold Fury, secure them that 5th and 6th item. We can already see Shred has basically got all 5 items online, just looking to sell that Bluestone Pendant after he is able to return to base soon.
Okay, here's something that I haven't seen for a while, because we don't really see much Hercules. He's a solid pick. Gauntlet of Thebes, however, is an item that we rarely see. It's a strong item. Item increases all healing by 20%. So that really buffs himself with that, I can't remember what it's called, with Mitigate Wounds, of course. So it's a strong item, it gives a lot of health, HP 5 as well, but I don't know, why do we not see it that often on things like, I don't even know what you would build it on other than a Herc.
Well, the problem is with the Gauntlet of Thieves is quite simple. It only gives health and HP 5, it doesn't give protections on either side. So essentially, you're sacrificing an item slot to get more healing and more health. This can work in the favor of Shred, because Shred is known for being aggressive, and the whole point of mitigate wounds is the more damage you take, the more you heal up after the duration. And since we've been seeing Shred really going ham in these teamfights, Gauntlet of Thieves will be keeping him nice and alive, even when he gets abducted, feather stepped, and combine that with the detonate charge, where Shred may have fallen before, he can now survive. However, I would have much rather see the Bulk of Hope, since they are dealing with a Zeus as well as the Kabrakan, and there's just so much magical damage on the side of Llamas in Pyjamas.
I would have definitely liked to see a bit more magical protection. Good abduct. Oh no, not a good abduct. What am I talking about? The Earthbreaker onto Tori. Gold Fury once again being started up here by Deadweight. Good driving strike onto Runner as well. The Beads is down. Crush coming through in a second. No, that's going to be a Scarab's Blessing to keep him alive. Ogre looking to dive the back line. Finds it with an easy kill onto Runner. Varana. And now Llamas in Pyjamas really need to back out of this fight. Good pull there from onto Tori Skies, but he gets hit into the crush as well. Good stun there from Shrix, looking for the ultimate onto Horizon and Agony, but Horizon does fall down to the Tremors from Shrix, and he's looking to go once again, finds a double kill from Shrix, and now Ogre might be in a bit of trouble as well. Shrix looking for his third. He knows that he's running around in this area, but Shred is here to keep him alive.
And now this is Blonde Retriever Deadweight, as they know they're going to get caught out. A nice blink in from Zachariah will possibly pick up the kill.
Taunt.
However, we've got a beautiful taunt. Ogre pick up the kill on Zachariah. Now Shred getting pulled in, as well as the lightning is just constantly applying to Shred. However, Shred is just too tanky, and the mitigate wounds is just keeping him alive. This could possibly have very easy. This is now just going to force Llamas back into retreat. Runner, 1BF for another 10 seconds, and they just don't have enough damage to do Gold Fury, as the lightning storm was used earlier.
I like the call from Llamas in Pyjamas to just maybe farm up a bit. Don't go for Gold Fury. Ogre did get out of that fight and was coming back at full health, and Swifty doesn't have any relics online, no purification, no sanctuary server. He did get caught out doing that Gold Fury. He would have fallen down guaranteed to the hands of only good at solo. Again, it's a good fight for Deadweight. Llamas still keeping a lead in kills. Looking into our graphs, the gold experience, should I say, is basically even once again, still gold in favor of Deadweight due to the two Gold Furies they've picked up. Fire Giant, actually, by Deadweight?
However, there's no Warders actually in the Fire Giant pair, and the only one
who's
actually relatively close is Shurix. They actually can very easily do this. And now Horizon is coming, and Agony is now all five members. That is a three Fire Giant at 29 minutes. That's an extremely bad play, but warding by Llamas. That should have been warded by now. It's that point of the game where they can easily take it. And now this could easily mean Deadweight are now just going to push down that middle lane. Nice taunt coming out from Wave.
Looking to go into the mid lane. Agony using that armor monster. Swifty gets instantly revived, but in the back line comes Shred with a boulder. Finds Swifty under the tower. Runner and Horizon as well. Swifty looking aggressive here. No, it's going to be Shurix with a good ultimate. Gets knocked up into the air. So make sure that the escape for Deadweight is guaranteed. Three members are running away at this point. Weave taken extremely low. He's stuck in between four members of Llamas in Pyjamas. Shred still juking it out, trying to find in the back line. Zachariah falls down, driving strike onto Tori. And Shred should be able to get out of this one. He's in a bit of trouble, but he's a very tanky Hercules.
And he's just going to walk away. He's just slowly walking back to that tier 2 tower. They don't have enough damage. With the gravity surge down. Yeah, that's basically it. They went a little bit too aggressive Deadweight there. They had that Fire Giant advantage. However, it's Runner with a Wind Demon as well as that Hidden Dagger, which will be most likely going into either a Malice or a Deathbringer. Under tower, you can't just dive that, especially with the Caledonian Ball. That's just going to spell disaster. And you saw, that was a very easy pickup. All Runner had to do was just simply stand on the tower and pick up some of the easiest kills of his life.
Yeah, Runner just picking up the kills. He's really get, even if he gets one kill in a fight, it changes the entire team fight. He picks off Horizon. We've seen him pick off Ogre a few times as well. If Runner can just find one of these crucial picks, Deadweight need to completely reset and rethink their strategy, because their major damage dealers have been taken out by an Artemis, and it's going to be a 4v5 with a tanky with Shurix just diving your front line as well, just doing so much damage, with Runner just outputting those basics left, right, and center with that attack speed buff as well. It's a vicious combo, and they need, either they take out Runner, or I don't know, they end up losing.
They need
these
to take
fights.
Out not Tori, sorry, Zachariah. Like Zachariah, he's been making the plays this game. 7-2-4 out of the 15 kills. However, over in the mid lane we see an engagement breaking out.
Sick, I'm not gonna find anyone. There's that ultimate coming through from Shrix. Execute doesn't find anyone, however. And Ogre's just trying to look away. Zach lurking in this jungle. Doesn't manage to find anyone just yet. Could be looking to go for a knock-up here. only good at solos, beads are down for another 40 seconds, so a knock up onto him would be perfect for Llamas in Pyjamas. But Deadweight are going to reset. They're going to keep their Fire Giant buff on the three core players they have with that buff and just look for a little bit more farm to finish off those crucial items.
And now, with Fire Giant, actually, the Fire Giant buff is going to end pretty soon. It's only one more minute of that buff on them. With Horizon no longer having that Fire Giant buff, it's going to be a lot harder to push this tier 1 mid tower, with Llamas being so defensive.
Oh, fighting mid lane though, Rana Barana using the beads to get out of the taunt there. And now Tori's going to be leading the charge. Zach taking down just over half health. That is that ultimate coming down from Swift. He doesn't find too much, and it's a good Sikkim Crush combo onto Tori, and the Sanctuary was used. Good reset now for Llamas, but they need to be aware that the full five-member force of Deadweight are going to be charging down that mid lane. Good taunt. I'm a monster coming through. Doesn't find too much, but Horizon finds the kill onto Shrux, and there's that Scarab's Blessing used onto Tori. Shred in the back line is going to be diving the tower and tanking that. Finds the boulder onto Tori, and he has to get out now, tanking with that mitigate wounds, and Horizon's going to be here to push down that tower, looking for the tier 2 now. Deadweight and Llamas need to defend at this Phoenix. They can't be looking to defend here. Torn onto Swifty, beads coming through. And now Rana Barana might be in some trouble himself.
However, Horizon picks up a very easy kill on Zachariah. And now this will be two towers to fall in a span of around 10 seconds. Deadweight always seems to win the teamfights when Llamas, they always seem to counter aggress, and that's when they win the teamfights, waiting for that Wheelix. And now Swifty getting taunted out. There comes the crush. Wow. Weave picks up a very easy kill.
Deicide.
Phoenix falls. This is going to be time. They have the Defender of Olympus on it. This is game. 33 minutes in, and Deadway completely turning around what thought was a very close game to just an absolute blowout, as now they just take that game off just a single team fight.
Yeah, that was very, very strong there at the late game. That's what we were saying in that draft and during that game. Llamas in Pyjamas were looking very, very strong with a few early kills, but it's all about that late game, ladies and gentlemen. The strong team from Deadweight with that, with the Scylla, of course. Horizon playing that Shibalonke. The late game was just too strong, and Weave playing out of his mind on that Athena. You can't look to have that on a team. You need to really be banning away Athena. Come on, guys. It's too strong to have.
The problem is, every single member of Deadweight, you could say, I want to ban this against them. Even Horizon, who's a sub, you can still say, I want to ban this away.
I want to ban Hoyi. I want to ban Kabrakan. You can't just focus ban one person.
And also, like, during that thing, like, that team fight was the result of the fact that they were trying... Basically, Llamas tried to play Deadweight's game in the late game. Yeah. And they tried to be aggressive. However, they just extended that little bit too much. And that's when they pounced. Deadweight are the kings of positioning. And I'm going to keep saying it and shouting it from the heavens, because it is so crucial in Smite that your positioning is on point. And Deadweight will always abuse. If you're just 1 centimeter out of position, they will abuse it. And that's how they were able to clinch that DS side and win the game.
Alrighty, guys, we'll be back in a second for game number 2. Can it be a split for Llamas in Pyjamas? We'll have to find out. We'll be back in just a second.